Welcome back to Let's Interactively Play Steve Jackson's Sorcery. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. This, as always, is a interactive Let's Play, where at the end of the video you get to choose from one of the choices presented in the majority rules for the vote Majority rules, so whoever, you know, whatever gets the most votes will be going forward in the next episode. I kinda messed that up. How did this even happen? Right. We knocked on the door of the commander's office, the commander of the guard. We want to see the commander. We have important information, we say. And here he is. Khartoum. He has a high-pitched voice and says, "Who is this?" And one of the guards... Well, actually, no, it was him that says, "It's almost certainly the Annalander wearing a cheap monk's robe. We told him we are not the Annalander. But apparently he's smarter than we think, wretch." "Who do you claim to be, then? And we are on a mission." He leans forward, interested, yet not convinced. Interested. Typo. A guard begins to speak, but is quieted by a look from her captain. "What kind of mission?" "A mission for the Archmage." Khartoum snots. I'm guessing... I remember that. I was laughing over that last time. At the end of the last episode. Guessing that should be snorts. "Oh yes, tell me then, what is his password?" "There is no password." "Of course there is, you simply don't know what it is," he replies. "What a pathetic lie." "There are quite a lot of guards here." Now, majority votes, 2 out of 3 votes. I get 5 likes and only 3 votes. Go figure. We're gonna cast the T-E-L, the tell spell, telepathy. To try to find out the password. Great idea, guys. Let's hope it works. You move the starlight into order around you, pulling on the cloth skull cap as you do so. The commander's thoughts seem to filter into your head. He's debating whether to send word to the Archmage about you or to simply kill you on the spot. What would Celestine do? He wonders to himself sadly. He is thinking of the portrait on the wall behind him. You slip the skull cap off your head. Unfortunately, we didn't get the password out of him. I guess he wasn't actively thinking about it. We'll try to use this to our advantage, then. These are all the options that were there before. Other than casting a spell, this and this and this all seem like not so great ideas. "I am a friend of Celestine," you declare boldly. The commander narrows his eyes. "What trickery is this?" "I met a woman called Celestine," you begin, looking at the portrait. "She looked like that woman." The effect is immediate, as though the commander had been struck across the mouth. He collapses backwards into his chair. "Get out," he murmurs weakly to the guards. "All of you, clear the room. You hear me? Get out." The guards nod and leave, and you are left alone with the commander. He points with shaking fingers. "Tell me. Now." "A few questions first." "You damn mercenary," he scolds back. "What do you want?" And I realize he talks in the high voice, so I don't really want to bother with that right now. "What secures the vault of the Archmage?" You begin. "It's a word of power, but I don't know it. The Archmage doesn't trust anyone that far." "What is the source of the Archmage's power?" "Knowledge," the commander replies quickly. "The Archmage is the greatest seer that has ever lived, or so they say. He knows everything that everyone has done or will do, because he sees them do things before they do them." "And don't you think I've forgotten that right now?" "I haven't." "What do you know of the Inner College?" He shrugs. We don't go in there. There are things. Powers, forces, creatures. It's where magic was researched in the ancient times. Now the magic is rotten into the stone themselves. Only the most powerful sorcerer or the luckiest rogue could survive it. Well, we've done... Well, we've died a few times, actually. Other than that, we haven't done too bad. He wipes a hand over his eyes. Tell me where she is, won't you? Celestine was in Kari. You lie. You met her? He seems stunned. Excellent. Why would you call a woman a swordsman? Briefly. He nods. His eyes lower for a moment. And she mentioned... me? I am sorcerer. Ugh. She wanted to tell me the whole story? What whole story? Of how... of him? Of how they met or something? I'm afraid if I say this, he's gonna say, okay, what's the story? I said I was heading for Mam Peng. You reply. When she heard that, she did nothing but talk of you. He frowns deeply, but... Okay, he's saying, but she didn't know I was from Mam Peng. I never told her. Women know things, you reply, and to your relief the lovesick commander nods. True, he replies. He even bows his head to you. True. They do. He stands and paces over to the window, looking out across the yard. Finally he turns back to you. So? He asks. What should I do? True, women do know things, including me. Go to her. He stares at you. The Archmage does not take kindly to traitors. Then we had all better act quickly. He all but snarls at you, but does not contradict. There's a clatter of armor outside the door. Guards are passing this way and that. You had better leave, he mutters. Quickly. You nod and hurry away, feeling rather pleased with yourself. You have found 2 new clues, and other clues have been updated. Yay, what we got? The inner vault ward. Word, sorry. The inner vault requires a secret word. True. The portrait of Celestine. Commander Khartoum has a portrait of a woman named Celestine on his wall. Now something was updated? Oh, the abandoned college? The long abandoned rooms of the inner college of Mam Peng are overrun by... By what? Overrun by old... magics. Hope you can hear me over all that. I want to make my way back to the college now. You emerge from the commander's doorway. The sun disappears, heading toward the horizon. You stand in the shadow of the tall tower. An iron door leads south out of the courtyard next to the commander's door. I guess this. So we're gonna head back. And try to finish this crap. Of which... Is this the Tower of Doors? I know we definitely have these to do. Not completely sure about these three. So yeah, let's head... Open the iron door. You open the iron door. 2 birdmen stand on the other side, facing away from you, blocking the way. You might be able to pass them, but movement for monks is most likely restricted in this part of the citadel. There is only 1 way to go, up the Sorcerer's Spike and the Throbin doors. Oh, jeez. Do I dare try to go through here anyway? I'm not done with the College of Magic. Oh, good. You open the door a little wider and step through. The birdmen look you over with cold eyes, but you are not turned back. On the other side of the doorway is a narrow alley. listen at the narrow door. Leaning over to press your ear against the narrow door, you hear high-pitched murmurs through the old wood. You peer through a crack in the door. You see a low table scattered with feathers. You try and shift your view, but there isn't much more to see. Definitely feathers. Alright. I thought there's a room. Moving quickly, you slip inside the door. Oh, this door. Oh. Okay. You slip in before the guard decides to investigate. The chamber you enter is rough, as though carved from a spur of rock. The ceiling is open to the sky. But as you enter, three birdmen look up from their dice game, staring at you intently. You're reminded of an Annalan phrase, hiding from snatticats in a stranglebush. Greet them? Maybe these are the rebels. Greetings. The birds continue to stare, dumbfounded. Oh, isn't that the thing? The clue about their mothers. Wait. You were told to ask after their mothers. Okay. The Birdmen of Shin. You take a step forward. Are your mothers well? The atmosphere changes in an instant. One of the great birds sucks in her breath.
Who are you?
She hisses.
Why did you ask us that?
I'm curious. The stocky one laughs.
No one is curious about a birdman's mother, or anyone else's for that matter.
The bird maid leans forward to stare you down, her hand on her sword.
Why are you here?
It's a password, isn't it? Some kind of code. They look at each other.
You are very clever, one says. Too clever for most who wander Mampang.
You wait, holding your breath. They stand up, and then they bow.
We are no ordinary birdmen, the stocky one says. My name is Pewit. This is Zetra and Felwip. We are the Samaritans of Shin. It's a pleasure to meet you, Annalander.
Or to meet the Annalander. Samaritans?
We are a group of birdmen dedicated to overthrowing the Archmage, as has been a very long road.
Why do you hate the Archmage?
Because our people are not free,
Pewit shouts. Zetra glares at him and he quiets.
We might dance in the skies, we might be poets, philosophers, musicians, but the Archmage keeps us as mere brutes.
What can you tell me about the Citadel? You ask.
It is a terrible place, the Birdman replies sadly. But the people themselves are not terrible. There is hope in every heart, only it has been buried a long time.
Pewit clasps your hand and smiles broadly.
But you are the one we have been waiting for. Come, we will help you.
How can you help me?
How else? We'll take you to him.
How? Pewit laughs and rustles his feathers.
How do you suppose? We'll go up.
The creature stretches its wings and half flaps, half leaps onto a crossbeam below the open roof.
Will you come with me?
He lowers his lower claws for you to stand beneath. Each talon is razor sharp, and the muscles joining them to the feet are like the pistons of mining machines, where'd that come from? You are quite certain with the slightest movement they will crumble your bones to dust. These talons are twitching as the birdman waits.
Back away. Can we come another time?
You back away. I will not.
Bah!
Replies Pewit.
Then be gone, feeble creature, and die alone.
Zetra smiles with half her beak.
You can smile with a beak? We will aid you in other ways if we can. Now go, and keep our secret.
Secret. With a final glance at your secret allies, you leave the room. Your clues have been updated. Yeah, I'm not ready. I want to finish the magic. The college. I don't know if it's that. I'm not sure which thing was updated. Alright. You step out into the alley once more. Only the guarded iron door remains. You cast a sidelong glance at the guards by the far door, sizing them up. They are birdmen, tall, strong, with savage clawed talons and beaks like pickaxes. One is missing a wing. They have seen you, but do not approach or call out, instead holding to their posts. It is most unnerving. The iron door is a large slab, guarded by two birdmen. They have seen you, but have yet to react. This door must lead into the inner fortress proper. Does. Beyond the iron door, you can make out movement in the yard beyond. Let's try to go down the alley. I guess they're standing here. You pause by a squat door. The sun is now in the lowest quarter of the sky. Okay. So I guess these are all rooms. The door is about chest height and is hanging open. A small bell with a pull string is set above it. Ring the bell. Ding-a-ding! You pull on the string and the bell rings gently. There are some scuffling sounds from within. After a few seconds, the door opens a fraction more. Well, come in then. You can't see who is speaking, but they have a very squeaky voice. And I can see each one of these is a room. Let's see who's got the squeaky voice. Ducking to enter, you discover that everything in this room is tiny. Chairs at knee height, a 3-foot-long bed, and ceiling to match. Trying to make out. Are these eyes here? And teeth? That's a head, right? Precariously sitting in one of the chairs is either a very small ogre or a hairless, ugly dwarf. Greet it. Approach it. Greetings, you declare. The creature blinks twice and turns its head, finally noticing you. Well, it demands. Come to laugh? Or are you come to bless me? To bless you. This is some kind of a mutant, but a fairly unremarkable one. Its main appearance is one of stockiness and grumpiness. Why would I laugh? I'm not stupid, you know. People think I am, but I'm not. Bah! Looking at the room, you notice how disproportionate the creature is. It is far too large for the tiny furniture. Even though it is small, the room appears designed to make it seem like a giant. I'm not going to laugh at you. The small creature looks at you with wonder. Why not? It is quite wrong. The creature sits down sharply. Huh. I wasn't expecting that, it grumbles. Who are you? Nibdom, Nibdom replies. I'm here because the Archmage finds my condition amusing. Condition? It grimaces. I'm a mutant. A failed experiment. What sort of experiment? You might well ask, it scowls. The Archmage was trying to cross ogres and dwarves. He wanted something strong and loyal as an ogre, but small enough to fit into the mines. So why are you here? Didn't work, it shrugs in reply. I'm the last, I think. Archmage keeps me around to cheer himself up. His little joke. Do you know the Archmage? You ask. Hardly. He's the one who forces me to live in this pint-sized room, though he rarely visits. You haven't seen him? Nibdom's ranting is cut short. What? No, not recently. He's been holed up in a tower of his. He's plotting something. What is he plotting? You demand. How should I know? The creature retorts. Maybe he plans to cross a birdman with a woodlouse or something. The passage outside ends in a door, you remark. But the guards won't let you through, Nibdom finishes. This place, I swear, if you all stop scheming and backstabbing for the Archmage's favor, Mampang would conquer the world. Perhaps that's for the best, you muse, forgetting yourself. It doesn't seem to notice. Of course, the Mampang Empire would finally find something even worse for me to do. Thanks for the chat, Nibdom says. I don't get to talk to many people these days. It stays in its chair, smiling ever so slightly. All right. Nibdom. You're in the alley once more. You had better keep moving. Agreed. Back to the junction. The junction of the ways. You return along the narrow alleyway. Look at the door. The door is unmarked and remains unlocked. The wood is warped and rain-sodden. I'm guessing we're looking at this door? To this room? Looking ahead, you see doors leading off on either side of the alley. It would be a good idea to not stand around too long. Gotcha. Turreted room. The door opens easily and you step inside. The stone walls form a cool, quiet space. Outside, night has fallen. This is clearly someone's quarters once, but they have long since cleared out, leaving nothing behind but a dent in the straw that lines the wall. You hunt through the straw a little, then pull your hand sharply back as something bites you. You look down at your fingers to see... I lost two stamina. You look down at your fingers to see two large red welts growing on your forearm. If that is a rat bite, then so be it. But if it is a spider, it could be quite serious. Don't think it would be a good idea to set fire to something in this small space. Let's stab the straw with my sword. You stab the straw a few times, and after a moment, a yellow-striped snake slithers out and darts away across the stones and under the door. Time to move on. Hey, I wanted to sleep! Let's see if I can go back in there. You return to the alley. The bite on your hand itches furiously, and then the welts begin to fade once more. You would do well to find some place to rest. Get back in here. I can't rest in here. You return to the alley. The night air is cool and good for walking. So much for resting. The alleyway runs to the right, but to the left is a low iron doorway. The door down to the city is locked. The doorway has a tiny grill at eye level from which floats a rich smell of what might be burnt meat. We need food. The alleyway is narrow and disappears out of sight between the outer and inner walls of the fortress. Try a key? You try your keys in turn, but nothing fits the lock. You could approach the door or make your way down the alley, but there is no way back over the palisade. Approach the door? Oh, the door to this? Oh. Got it. To this. Maybe we'll find a key in here. The night is drawing on. You stand by a solid metal door set into the stone wall. You don't fancy your chances of breaking it down. The door is dented and scratched, as though people have tried to break it down before, but all the dents point outwards into the alley, as though what was inside had tried to escape. Fortunately, perhaps the door is firmly locked. There's a tiny grill at eye level. You put your eye to the grill, and a moment later someone pokes it with a finger. You stagger back, blinking furiously. "Who's that?" demands a voice through the door. "Who is this?" "I asked first," returned the voice sullenly. "I'm a monk, here to bless you." "That's why the person asked me if I'm here to bless them." "There's no blessing that can save me," returns the voice. "Besides, I enjoy what I do." "Let me in," you demand. "Why?" "I'm curious." You answer, "What's inside here?" "Oh, you'd like to know, would you?" replies the voice. "Then you're most welcome." You hear the grinding of machinery, then a click as the door swings forward on its own accord. A short, wide corridor is in front of you, but there is no sign of any guard. "Who's there?" There's no reply. Whoever you were talking to seems to have vanished. Walk forward. You make your way cautiously forward. The middle of the room seems very exposed, but the walls might be set with any number of hidden traps. Let's go to the left wall, I guess? As you walk down the corridor, you hug the left wall. Halfway down, a huge flail swings down from a hidden chain, filling the rest of the corridor. You hear a resounding laugh echoing from a chamber through a low arch at the far end. So whoever this is enjoys what he or she or it does. Which is what? Set traps? Make torture instruments? The chamber. Another mutant? You duck through an archway and nearly gag from the stench. Dried blood paints the walls and floor, and scattered around the room are grisly instruments of torture. Standing in the middle of the room is a bowed, ugly ogre with a huge grin and a dozen scars. He wears a ragged black hood and carries a whip. Yeah, he likes to torture and make stuff. Enjoy my sure prize? He asks, voice lisping. No. Ha! He beams with evident satisfaction. Gush! Who are you? He peers at you. Yoosh don't know? He demands. Well now, and whoosh or yoosh? Okay, he wasn't talking like this when we were on the other side of that door. Well, a guard, but I'm wearing monk's robes. A merchant? Just a traveler. He's on you before you can even speak, knocking you down with a massive club. The Shoal Fortress is alive with talk of an intruder, and you expect me to trust a stranger? For a moment, all is quiet and peace. Your mother's voice talks to you softly, singing a lullaby as she strokes your head. Stay asleep, she murmurs. There's no need to wake up now. Stay with me. Mother? Be still, little goat, she smiles. Do not struggle. Just let your eyes close. You're safe with me. She sits beside a stream, dangling her fingers in the water. The gurgling water runs bright red. I'm going to shake myself awake. This is a dream, of course, but a beautiful one all the same, and sometimes dreams are more pleasant than reality. Because he's like killing me or something, I don't know. You come to, all but gagging from the stench. The room you are in is truly ghastly. Dried blood paints the walls and floor. Scattered around the room are grisly instruments of torture. Your arms are chained to the wall. The scarred ogre shuffles over and takes a bow. Naggamanteh, he declares. Master Torturer of Mamping. Welcome. You must be... Tishintrisher. What? Our French out soon enough. Read it from your entrails, I wish. A mad glint in his eyes evident. He clearly loves his work. Okay, we have many choices. You look around. There are hooked knives, flat pokers, and fine needles, and more. Naggamanteh lets you soak in this host of grisly instruments. You are doing this work for him. Okay, I don't think this is going to help anything. I don't think pleading will help either. He enjoys his work. Talk to him. Distract him somehow. Let's try talking to him. Listen, you begin. Oh, I'll listen. Once you start screaming. Naggamanteh interrupts. He picks a tool off the rack and brandishes it near you. It's a small knife with a sharp hook at the end. Want to know what this is for? No. You shout, your voice shrill. Oh, I'm sorry, he says. I short you new sash with rhetorical. I teach by example only. He steps behind you out of... Oh God, we lost 2 stamina. Out of your sight, there is a blinding flash of pain from your hand, and when he comes back around, he is holding your little finger. He chuckles, then pops it into his mouth. Oh God. You can hear your bone crunch between his jaws. Then he watches you expectantly. Crack a joke? I would like to try to distract him now, but that's not an option. I've got 9 more where that came from, you mutter back. Naggamanteh looks you dead in the eye, then roars with laughter. He laughs until he's short of breath. Shash might be the first joke I ever heard in Shear. He shakes his head and wipes his eye. You're an odd one. It's not fun wish you don't blubber. How you so strong? He pulls up a stool. Come now, a good story, and I might not stab you any mush. All right, tell him my story. You speak at length about your travels, leaving out the parts about the crown of kings
Naggamanteh laughs and cheers along, clearly not believing a word of it.
Lisht... What is that supposed to be? Lisht to reveals the past?
He shakes his head.
Fantastic.
Lists? Lists? Is he saying lists? Lights? I don't know what that word's actually supposed to be.
Do you keep on talking? You should explore the inner college?
He backs away a bit.
It is a place of great power.
He peers at you.
Sorcerer, then, are you?
Just brave.
He considers this for a moment. Welsh, he nods. Perhaps you'll be interested in Nish.
Naggamanteh stomps over to a cool-looking machine, a slab of rock covered in straps and chains. Above it, all manner of nasty things are suspended from what resembles a giant spider.
My babish.
My babish, he declares. Steeling yourself, you look at more closely at the legs of the machine. They are sheathed in wood and metal, but you can see living flesh pulsing here and there. The arms are connected to an orb of metal and bone, which hums with magical energy.
The pleasure,
Naggamanteh declares.
The what? The pleasure,
he replies.
The pleasure?
Naggamanteh blushes a nasty green color.
Nash, my dears, once I had a poet here, and I tried to get her to help me, but she lost her mind with terror and couldn't say anything except plish.
Quite disappointing. Oh, pleaser? What does it do? You continue, stalling for time.
Ish fabulous. Depends on a person... Descend on a person, swallowing them up. A swollen mess of streaming and shush. Shen Shishfia spits out a corpse.
It's killing me talking like this.
Or did you mean what should do on the shin side?
Shin on the inside? He stumps over to the wall.
Show more time to wish.
Naggamanteh unhooks your chain from the wall and gives it a sharp tug, sending you sprawling. But one of your hands slips free as he does it. You conceal it quickly as he drags you toward the machine.
The pleasure.
The pleasure. Naggamanteh drags you towards the pleasure and hoists you into it. Now that you are close, you can see the machine in all its sick glory. There are no obvious weaknesses or mercies. The sight of it fills you with dread. Naggamanteh secures you into place, but he fails to notice your free hand. The sphere hovers above you, but it is lowering. Okay. I think looking up would cause a round to pass and we'll die. Screaming is probably exactly what he wants. It's not going to help. Cast a spell? This might be another spell thing. And I realize I forgot to cause depression. Let me get my notes here. Alright. Sap is depression. That might work on him. No, no. I gotta put a maximum of 4 choices just so it doesn't... I can't summon a Snatticat. There's nothing else. That's all the S's. Okay.
The pressure.
We don't have the pebble. Talk all languages. Well, we can already talk to him. Doubt we can talk to the machine. Turn to stone, we don't have the item for that. That's gonna use half our stamina. Rather not do that. Ditto with the lightning bolt. Teleportation. Zip.
Teleportation. That laughter you hear in the background sometimes. R, Z. There's only two things. S. I got Y over here. Oh, didn't we? We've done that. We've done that. Ooh. Summon a giant. Summon giant. Didn't I look at Yap? Isn't that talk? Talk with animals. With animals, yeah. I had another talk with things. Understand all languages was the other one. Yeah. That's it. Three choices. Spells to cast. Hopefully this time I'll remember to put them over here. One of three choices, guys. Use the sap spell to try to cause depression on this guy. Depression. Use the zip spell to teleport out of here. Could be dangerous. Could teleport anywhere. Could teleport inside solid stone around this place. I don't know. But it's a way out. We'll teleport somewhere. Who knows? Maybe I teleport just a foot away. But, worth a try, I think. Or the Yob spell to summon a giant. So let me know what you guys choose. Cast your votes in the comments section below. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Thanks for voting. And endure. In enduring, grow strong. See you next week.